A man in prison was able to steal $11 million by impersonating billionaires, and it actually worked while he was at a maximum security prison in the state of Georgia. You won't believe this. Put up his picture full mass here. According to the allegation, authorities believe that man on the left, Arthur Lee Cofield Jr., impersonated the man on the right, Sidney Kimmel, who puts a lot of money behind major movies and also major nonprofits. Let me give you the background to what happened. Authorities say some $11 million was somehow swindled from various financial institutions by someone pretending to be a billionaire, actually a slew of billionaires, and using cell phones to facilitate the schemes from prison. Once again, a maximum security prison. Federal prosecutors have identified Arthur Lee Cofield Jr. as the person who impersonated Sidney Kimmel, a California billionaire, while being locked up in the Georgia Department of Corrections Special Management Unit. Yes, he was in a maximum security prison who had a special management unit overseeing him. But somehow he was still able to pull off what has been called the greatest heist of any person ever from prison. Okay, he was serving 14 years for armed robbery, according to Fox News. Cofield was able to get cell phones into the prison. That is a form of contraband. It is against the rules. He utilized this contraband to execute his deals. One deal he allegedly arranged allowed $11 million to be wired from Kimmel's Charles Schwab account to an Idaho company to purchase 6,106 American Eagle 1 ounce gold coins. Then he did something else. The prosecution also believes he charged a private plane to transport the coins from the gem state into Atlanta, and then allegedly used the proceeds to buy $4.4 million house in Buckhead, Georgia, very affluent community. Originally, the house was not up for sale, but the owner, Michael Zambilis, agreed to sell the house to Cofield, but changed his mind with a $500,000 cash deposit. So the case was first announced by the Justice Department, okay? This was back in December of 2020. And for 2 years, they've been building their case, Atlanta Journal-Constitution reveals. The DOJ has indicted Cofield and two others accused of being associates on the outside. Eldridge Bennett, 65, and his daughter, Aliyah Bennett, 27, of conspiracy to commit bank fraud and money laundering. The three have all pleaded not guilty. Authorities also suggest there may have been others who have fallen victim to this criminal enterprise. Many commentators on Lipstick Alley believe that the dramatics of Cofield's escapades could be great on the big screen. This is made for movie stuff. One person said, and I quote, "This will make a good movie." In disbelief, another person wrote a similar thought. What in the American greed kind of story is this? How in the hell is this man able to commit such brazen and multifaceted scams? He obviously has inside people and help from those inside with him. COs, meaning correction officers included. Just think, what kind of things could he do if he applied his obvious smarts to doing right? This could be a movie. One person simply said, wow. Impressive. Who is Kimmel? Kimmel is the chairman and the CEO of the Sidney Kimmel Entertainment Company and is one of the producing forces for Hollywood films like Crazy Rich Asians, Hell or High Water, and Moneyball. The 94-year-old founder of Jones New York is worth about $1.5 billion after selling the company for $2.2 billion. Matthew Kamens, who is Kimmel's advisor, gave a statement regarding the crime. The quote is, Mr. Kimmel was unaffected by whatever occurred and we have no knowledge of what occurred, either in terms of background or context. After the banks were made aware of the fraud, Kimmel was fully reimbursed by the banks. Wow. Okay, where do I start? So first of all, obviously, nobody should be stealing money that does not belong to them. That's called theft, and it's not right. Let's also look at the fact that somehow this individual is out of prison, managed by a special management unit, was able to pull off this kind of heist, this kind of theft. What is being called today as the largest financial theft in the history of America from someone incarcerated. How did he get all of these cell phones inside of this one building where he was under a special management protocol? I got questions. And if you know anything about these money management accounts, it's hard for you to get your own damn money out of your account. The kind of information they require you to verify, you have forgotten most of that stuff, okay? How was he able to bypass the protocols of Charles Schwab and anybody else in order to get this money, access the money, and then transfer the money to other accounts? I'll be damned. All right, got a lot of questions here. Obviously, they have caught on to the scheme, but they're saying not guilty. My dear brother, what are your thoughts here?
Well, my first thoughts when I was reading the story earlier was like, hey, why is their resemblance so uncanny? It looks like they used the same picture of the same person twice, side by side. Now, if this was going to be a made movie, I want to elect O'Shea Jackson Jr. to play the starring role. Ice Cube's son, he would dominate this situation.
Good choice.
Now, I'm wondering how Arthur Lee Cofield Jr. chose his targets. He seemed to strategically choose certain individuals, in this case, a billionaire and an additional millionaire, in order to rob them. But with all of this being said, I'm sure this isn't over. He has made it so far without being either caught or reprimanded enough to be able to stop. He's not done. This is going to continue.
Yeah, I mean, they're saying there are more actual victims, so they're not able to conclude that this was the last of the scheme. We'll continue to follow the story. Fascinating nonetheless.